him Dr. Associate. Maybe in a few weeks' time, while he will be coming frequently, that's when you will get to know when he must have defended. You just talked of the bar losing, you know, in the space of, if I've not forgotten 2 years or a bit, after 2 years, they have lost about three batonniers. The recent one is we have lost a batonnier Muna, we lost a Francis Asaga, if I have not forgotten, and the recent one is Chakunte, who just died, Chakunte Charles. I don't know, you are a legal mind. How do you look at such a devastating situation?
You know, the legal profession is complicated, but I must say that in as much as the legal field is complicated, there is free mind to always exercise your functions and your duties. Mm-hmm. But as it is not only within that domain that people are passing away. I think it is a call of God, and I must say that any person occupying such a position should not be afraid, because everybody can die at any moment. So we don't know. It is a call of nature, and we can't debate about that. So what I want to call on them is to always be patient and to rely on God, to trust more in God, because if God can extend the years of Peninsula, I mean, a guru in the Bible, why not extend their lives too? So we will keep our fingers crossed and keep praying for the Bar Council so that we don't keep getting this kind of bad news, because it is very, very devastating and discouraging to many people whom I want to tamper into such an office. They might think that it's a death trap, but I want to call on them to feel, to have that confidence, because everywhere there is death. What we have to do is always to keep our fingers crossed and to prevent ourselves from moving into dangerous zones. Because, Mr. Moderator, most people who die prematurely, find some look for their death themselves, because they engage themselves in dangerous ventures where they have to, you know, people always say that life is risk.
Yeah.
You have to bear risk to be successful. So, but I want to also encourage the society to know the nature of risks they bear so that it will not endanger their lives and take their lives prematurely.
But Mr. Lingondo Joseph Mwambo, just at the age of, he was in his 50s, and it really frightened people. Uh-huh. And given that in the space of 2 years, three batonniers just going like that, and we saw most of them crying because he was somebody who was really backing the legal minds in Cameroon.
Well, I will say again that, as my learned colleague there said, I would like to know your name, sir. I'm sorry for that.
Yeah.
Mr. Armstrong, who is a legal mind, he said something, that death is inevitable.
Yeah.
And we should understand that if we go back biblically, we realize that people die at various ages. There are some people who died early, some people, Christ at the age of 33, he checked out, he has finished his mission. The most important thing on planet Earth is that you accomplish what you are supposed to do.
Okay.
If you have accomplished your goal, then you should check out gloriously. If it happened that he's dying at the age of almost 50, what I want to say here again categorically is that, did he accomplish his mission? If he had his mission which he was supposed to accomplish, then he accomplished his mission. Nobody wants to stay here forever. Okay. Even Methuselah, the oldest man in the Bible, who stayed for almost 1,000 years, still died. So if it happened that he's dying at this time, what I'm looking forward is that, did he accomplish his mission? If he has accomplished his mission, then we should celebrate him for the fact that he's gone gloriously. That's what I can contribute as far as that is concerned. Thank you.
Could it be that maybe somebody who was so outspoken, who maybe would have been used by the Cameroonese movement, during maybe to back them up in courts, is it a kind of handicap to some politicians like Professor Kamto?
First, Mr. Moderator, you permit me to extend my condolence visit to the biological family, that of Batonnier Charles Chakunte Party. but equally to the call of lawyers nationwide and in the diaspora. Once I've said that, I want to say, as the Bible rightly said, human life could extend up to 77 years.
Yeah.
And if late bâtonnier Charles Chakunte has gone up to half a century, I think we should be able to celebrate life. As we sit here, we are still praying that God should grace us with those number of years. But I equally want to share some regret seeing some position that he defended while he was still alive. I remember when the very extreme met Ndoki, when she was being captured by the dictatorial regime of Mr. Biya and jailed unjustly at Konengi. Late barrister Bâtonnier Charles Chakunte did everything to dissociate the function, the activity of a lawyer, of legal minds from that of politicians. And even when some lawyers grouped themselves and visited Kamto at the aftermath of his release from the maximum security center, Konengi, he equally came up powerfully to denounce that move, that lawyers had to wear their gowns into a private home. All those positions has helped Bâtonnier Chakunte to distinguish and wash his hand on political affairs. And so it is our concern to know that at a time when the judiciary arm of the government was not able to dissociate its activity, notably at the level of the judicial police, Bâtonnier Charles mobilized his colleague and his board to go on the street. I remember that was November 2019, and I remember how the county was shaking because they announced that they were to go on streets. And when we have all these memories standing by the side of human rights defense that is being now, that has lost its champion, and knowing that he has just been sworn into office, I think it is in 2018 or so. So for a 5 years mandate that he has just been seized away from life like that, I think the cold hand of death is very frightful. And I just want to be part of those who think that when you leave, seize the opportunity to create impact, because you don't know. Nobody knows when death is coming.
Yeah.
And so we need to act with a lot of energy so that humanity that is going to stay back will remember at least one thing about us. For Pati, we remember that he stood for human rights.
You know, what is very important on planet Earth is to leave a legacy.
Yes.
When you leave this life without a legacy, then you die like a chicken. You chicken out. We want to look at a retrospect of the time he was alive.
Yeah.
What is the impact which he created? That's what matters now, because it's in the past, it's a history. But as I rightly said again,
yeah,
the legacy which he has left,
yeah,
will ride on, will go on, will live on, you see.
The annals of history
yeah, is written. And so, if he has left a powerful legacy, just as my brother here said, then we have nothing to regret. We should celebrate him because he has done what he is supposed to do. We on earth are actors. We come to act our own part and we check out.
So you are saying that we should rather think of our own lives.
We should think of our own lives because, as I rightly said again, a person like me, I'm from a family of eight. Mr. Siri, I'm from a family of eight, four boys, four girls. My father died when he was just 42, 43. He created his impact by leaving eight children,
okay,
and a wife and these children. And all of us, we had to trail our path. And today, by the blessings of God, maybe in 2-3 weeks' time,
yes,
I'll become a doctor. If I die tomorrow, that's a legacy I've left.
Okay,
so if the legacy he has left is something which time and events will remember him, they will have nothing to regret about it. Thank you.
Thank you so very much. We say our condolences to the Chakunte family. We pray that may his soul rest in perfect peace. Dear viewers, at this time, we shall take the first topic where we shall be talking on the academic